Virginia City Grand Prix is an outlaw motorcycle race that takes place in historic Virginia City, Nevada, every year at the end of April. This two-day event regularly draws over 1,000 racers as they gather to battle the historic mountains for glory. This year's event will be the Angry Gnome Race Team's 10th showing, as it has raced since 2008. The weeks leading up to the race are always nerve-wracking, as it entails a lot of preparation and anxiety. Drive from Southern California alone is 8 to 10 hours and passes through some of the most beautiful country that California has to offer. We usually leave late Thursday and drive through the night to be there by morning. With a full tank of gas, we're off through the Mojave Desert and the Eastern Sierras. Halfway through our journey, the sun set over the mountains, and we were blessed with some fantastic views. We decided to pull into a little restaurant in Lone Pine called The Grill for some dinner. In all our years of passing this place, we never knew it existed. We had a delicious dinner, then hit Fort Independence gas station for some of the cheapest diesel on a 395. Virginia City sprang up in 1859 with the discovery of silver in the Comstock Lode. At the city's peak in 1878, there were 25,000 residents, and as of 2010, there were just 855. Early Virginia City settlers were mainly backwashed from San Francisco, and included many immigrant communities such as the Chinese and Irish. Virginia City is also known as the birthplace of Mark Twain because it is here that Samuel Clemens first used his pen name to write for the local Territorial Enterprise newspaper. As you walk the streets through the historic buildings, it's easy to see this place's rich history and the hardships the miners went through. The Grand Prix is definitely one of the only races worldwide that starts on the main streets of such an historic city. It bears the young and saves the old. It's a short time here and a long time gone. The workmen sing the people's song. We're here in VC. We picked up Special Ed for the race and
Factory Rider.
That's right. We got Safety back there. She's OSHA inspector. And we got Private Chumps Pyle. Forgot what he is. Oh, he's a prospector.
Prospector, yes.
And we're heading back out to VC. If you don't like Dodge, you can always go to Abilene. I hear the getting's plenty and the grass is always green. You can always head to Kansas City where they...
Here we are, stepping into MX Trophies. Gonna check out the awards for the riders. Sorry.
No worries.
There's Rick. Rick, go home.
Oh, there he is.
Thank you. What's going on, man?
Isn't there a little bit smaller?
This is Rick from MX School on YouTube here. Rick from MX Trophies. Check out what he made for us here.
Oh, dude.
Oh, it is our...
Sick. Look at that.
Acrylic, he made them. All the different years of the Gnome for the Sierra Nevada tap handle. Rick popped them in. He came up with the wood grain himself and made us a couple extras. Oh, sweet, dude.
That's badass. Awesome.
Thanks, man.
The guys at MX Trophies are some very good people. They design and produce trophies for all types of events, including the Supercross and Motocross circuits. They also design all of our shirts and apparel, as well as our Gnomey Award.
So these slide in here. I showed these to Rick this morning. And he came up with the idea of making the Angry Gnome tap handle. He does all of our gnome stuff.
Yeah.
So, to put it in terms you can understand, that's Monty, that's Safety, and that's Private Chum's Pile.
Awesome. Yeah, I crack up seeing those all the time.
Thank you.
This right here is the coveted Gnomey Award. Ed and I race for it. Other people are invited to race for it, but no one does.
That's right.
And it's very special to us. It's basically my dad on an award made by MX Trophies. And see right there? The only one on there, 2016, Danny Monty.
It's not as awesome as a gun, Eddie.
Only one on there. We'll be racing for that this weekend.
Cool. That one. The new team racing gear, 2017 VC. This one is for safety. She's our safety officer. There you go, Safety.
Oh, thank you.
And this one, Private Chump Spot.
Woo! 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 Woo!
The prospector.
Woo! 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 Woo!
Oh, you're sickening.
Got Monty's.
It's mine.
Sick.
So badass.
Oh,
let him relax.
This is supposed to be the long sleeve version, but you're gonna have to go short sleeve this year.
I didn't bring a long sleeve.
I got one.
Actually, Rob, my giant loop shirt. It'll be perfect.
Oh,
nice.
I love you.
52. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Except for I still ride it.
Everything wants orange. We almost paid like $150
extra. 8-inch hill is right here, but they cut out the body and the foot.
Friday afternoon and evening is our time to relax and have a couple of beers, seeing as we don't race until Sunday. We talk with Teabag and the Hales about our Baja trip and share stories about what's been going on since we last saw each other. Some of the Sierra Trail dogs race on Saturday, so they hit the sack early, but the Angry Gnome race team always heads up to the bars Friday night to take part in some of the nightlife. We don't get too radical because we still want to be up in time to see our friends start Saturday's race.
Now heading on up to the Red Dog, get a pie and some beer.
What's the Red Dog infamous for?
The Red Dog is infamous because 366 days ago, Joey passed out in there with his pants around his ankles.
And then
got lost and locked in.
We got safety. We got the vigils here. That's Tony Vigil.
I'm getting loaded for Baja. I'm getting loaded.
Get loaded for BC.
He's infamous. He's the one that put together, sponsored the whole Rip to the Tip, Tony Vigil. Rip to the Tip.
2017.
Title sponsor.
Yeah.
Tony Vigil 2016, 2017.
He's the one that sponsored the videos, brought to you by Tony Vigil. This is the man, the myth, the legend.
These are the hills we have to go up.
Danny, that was such a good edit.
Hillary brings out my
the IT side.
Yeah. My purpose.
Okay, let's have a beer. Are we going any back?
You do the same way on every single thing. Saturday's race is divided into the expert and amateur classes, with the amateur class being divided into the open, 30+, 40+, and 50+ classes. The bikes line up along Main Street, and the riders listen to the opening ceremony as Motormouth gives his speech, and they talk about the rules of the race. We always stop by to wish our friends good luck.
Ed's riding on Saturday.
Going Saturday, my new mojo.
Husqvarna.
But there's a spot that you can sign up for if you know anybody.
This is Nathan from Mojo.
Oh, nice.
This is my cousin Dan. He's in our video.
Nice to meet you, man. I do all the Instagram videos.
Oh, perfect.
This is your first time racing this race?
Second time? Yeah.
Oh, okay. Say something real quick.
Eat a bowl of dick.
Good luck, guys. Good luck.
Dear God, we come before you this day as the racers are gathered at the starting line to pray for their safety. We pray that as the race grinds on, they remain alert and have the stamina.
Thank you.
What's happening, Sharon?
Where's Danny and Lindsay?
He went to go get some new batteries.
Oh, there they are, right there.
Is this film on his camera?
So, what's up, Eddie?
What's happening?
Bloody Marys.
Bloody Marys VC 2017.
Ed Macias, title sponsor of the 2017 Virginia City Grand Prix.
Just trying to keep up with the Tony Vigils. That's it. Hey, look. There's Joe.
Where's Joe? He's not lost?
No.
Oh, Joe. Hey, Joe. 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 Sorry.
It's all right. It's early still.
Looking for Joe? You know where he's at? Give me a call at 867-5309.
He's on the, Joe's on the back of a milk crate now.
She's calling. Yeah. And she said,
There's an olive and a toothpick down on the bottom there.
Danny, backwards with your drink.
There you go.
So gross. So disgusting.
Don't look.
Yo, this is Donnie Bird.
Donnie.
Hello.
He's president of VCGP.
VC.
Yeah, the only guy dumb enough to keep driving the bus.
Yeah. Over.
I want to sit in the back.
Yeah. He's dumb enough to do it over and over and over.
But I do drive the short bus.
You run a post every year, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Boy, no doubt.
That should let you know what's up right there. VCGP 2017.
While we wait for Saturday's racers to come in on the first lap, we usually take this opportunity to get a Bloody Mary or two and eat some breakfast at the Delta.
Out of poplar or maple, for the pine and the walnut are gone. Secure your saddle on that old Palomino and ride till the stars seem to fall. What do you dream of when all that you wanted is given? Like the love of a girl who has long been a woman, long years after you've moved on. But sleep well. In the stillness of morning, when you hear one fragile bird song, alone with the truth, that is the worst kind of lonely.
There are many places along the course to watch the race, but we usually end up watching from somewhere in town. We like to watch the first big uphill out of town, as that is the one place where you can see the riders come into and out of the pit area.
Palomino, and the spark is fading faster than hope. And you think about three words left forever unspoken that altered the path that.
As the race comes to a close, we make our final preparations to our bikes so they are ready to go first thing in the morning.
It's not your fault.
We're here at the race on the starting line.
We got special ed receives here. We got Braden. We got Zahir. We got Private Tommy Kyle. And I'm not next to Ed. Ed got the gate position. He's gonna get the whole shot. I know. I always get the whole shot. So I'm gonna try hard this time to work it on the outside.
It's alright.
Zoom in, cut him off. We'll see. We got Dave on the same line with us and Josh. Dave went to Baja with us. So.
Before you this day, as the racers are gathered in the starting line, we pray for their safety. We pray that as the race grinds on, they remain alert and have the stamina to complete the race. We pray for the safety of those working on the course, so they will remain out of harm's way.
Came through the night that our flag was still there.
The lap is always the most nerve-wracking. The course is largely unknown to all the riders, and your adrenaline is usually rushing. As you head out of town, you wonder what kind of terrain will be included this year, and if there are going to be any bottlenecks. At this point going to Sucho Canyon, Ed passes me as I stall my bike. It's one of the most frustrating things seeing your lead slip away over a stupid mistake. Luckily, I catch back up to him pretty quick. This year's course was around 30 miles long. You must race for 3 hours, and your race is only done if you cross the finish line on your final lap after the 3 hour mark. This means that some people end up doing 4 laps, while others end up only doing 2. At this point, we both end up getting hung up on this hill. We get going pretty quickly after falling, but Ed never catches back up to me again for the entire race.
Right.
Until things shake out on the second lap, there are always bottlenecks, and the only way to deal with them is to weave your way through all the stuck riders. This infamous bottleneck is called Radiator Hill. It makes an appearance almost every year, but doesn't create much congestion when we run it downhill. This year's course was a little harder than usual. All the rain and snow Virginia City got washed the dirt away, and there were more rocks than usual. And there are usually already a ton of rocks.
Race now for about an hour, like 2 hours probably, and took a shower, got a hotel room, and now we're getting stuff ready for to leave, and we're getting ready to go up to get some food too. We're hungry. We have to get this breakfast, and actually we didn't really have breakfast, so I'd say that the race was freaking hard. Ed, what did you think of that race?
That was a tough one today. A lot of bottlenecks, a lot of rocks.
Why a lot of rocks?
It's Virginia City. Grand Prix back in town.
We haven't seen the official results yet, but who won?
It's unofficial right now. It's a little too close to call. We're going to have to go to the scoreboards on that. You don't get official times.
It was not close to call. It was about an hour I beat him by. So,
it's an hour when he only did two laps and I did three.
He did not do three.
Wait till you see the results.
Wait till we see the results.
Hold on. There we go. There we go.
Again.
You got it. That's all you need to do.
No, do the Joker. Do the Joker part, Joe.
We're all in a world of shit.
My brother's kind
of. He won today because I got stuck in a couple bottlenecks.
I beat him by 1 hour. By 1 hour, one full hour.
And
I threw my drone.
14 years younger than me. And this might be the second time this happened.
America.
We're gonna wait until next. America.
There's the Gnomey.
I want to thank the Academy.
It was rightfully earned.
I want to thank the Academy. I want to thank the Angry Gnome Adventure Race Team. I want to thank
Josh and his family, and I want to thank
Tony Vigil.
The Tony Vigil's ripped to the tip, 2016-2017.
The drive home was always bittersweet. I'm glad that no one in our group got hurt, and you can't beat the scenery. I also know that it's back to the real world and away from the motorcycle life I love so much. As we pass through Mammoth, we make it a tradition to stop at the brewery and have some beers. Joey always buys a growler that he can't finish, and Lindsay always gets her beer flight. This is always an adventure that brings a smile to my face and keeps me coming back for some more.
Say what you want, I don't mind. Say what you want, I don't mind. Say what you want. Silence took me, fierce and blindly, shadows.